Good morning, students. Today we discussed about anti-helminthics categories of drugs. So what's helminths? Helminths are macroscopic multicellular organisms having their own digestive, excretory, reproductive and nervous system. So helminthiasis, that means is a disease in which part of the body is infested with one or more intestinal parasite worms, like roundworm, tapeworm and fucus. The worms usually infest the intestine, but sometimes they may involve other organisms. So this anti-helminthics categories of drugs mainly used to eradicate, either kill or expel infesting helminths. So this main role is eradicating helminthus parasites. So first we come to the benzimidazole categories of drugs. From benzimidazole categories, mebendazole is a broad spectrum benzimidazole. Its pharmacokinetic is complete clearance of parasites from the GIT may take up to 3 days. Anti-helminthic action of mebendazole is inhibits cytoplasmic microtubule synthesis in nematodes. It also impairs their glucose uptake and secretion of acetylcholine esterase. Therapeutic uses, this mainly used as roundworm, hookworm, pinworm infections, tapeworm infections, trichuriasis, hydatid disease, multiple worm infestations. Mebendazole, usually it is used in case of ascariasis and anencyclostomiasis, 100 mg BD for 3 days. Trichuriasis, 100 mg single dose. For pinworm infestations, 100 mg OD repeated after 2 and 4 weeks. Intestinal capillariasis, 400 mg per day for 21 days. For tiniasis, 300 mg BD for 3 days. Main adverse effects are nausea, diarrhea, abdominal pain, alopecia, granulocytopenia may occur at high doses. Next come to this albendazole. Albendazole is another container of mebendazole. It also comes under the benzimidazole category. It is usually given only as a single dose. It is poorly absorbed from the GIT. Oral bioavailability being enhanced when this given with a fatty meals. Anti-helminthic action of albendazole, it blocks the glucose uptake of larval and adult stages of parasites, thereby depleting their glycogen stores. It also decreases the formation of ATP. Main therapeutic uses of albendazole, drug of choice in roundworm, hookworm, pinworm infestations, trichuriasis infestation singly 400 mg dose. Trichuriasis, tapeworm and strongyliosis 400 mg daily for 3 days. For neurocystic causes, firstly glucocorticoid should be given before starting albendazole to prevent immunological reactions to the dead parasites. For hydatid disease, albendazole 400 mg twice daily for 4 weeks. When the cysts are removed by surgery, albendazole is more effective. For filariasis, combination of albendazole with diethyl carbamazine or ivermectin given as single dose. These are some adverse effects: nausea, vomiting, epigastric distress, reversible alopecia. Main precautions and contraindications in case of hypersensitivity, cirrhosis of liver and pregnant woman. Next come to this thiabendazole. Thiabendazole is another benzimidazole category. It also possesses anti-inflammatory, analgesic and antiparatic action. It also inhibits the development of eggs of worms and kills the larvae. These are mainly used in alternative to albendazole in case of strongyliosis and cutaneous larval migraines. These are the adverse effects: nausea, vomiting, skin rashes, anorexia, giddiness, abdominal pain, diarrhea, fever, headache. Thiabendazole in case of trichuriasis and strongyliosis,
25 milligram per kilogram daily in 2 divided doses for 2 days after meals, if recurred repeated after 2 days. Next drug is levimisole. It is a synthetic imidothiazole derivative, highly effective in eradicating ascaris and anisocromiasis. It is an immunomodulating agent, and its effectiveness in various cancer, autoimmune disease, chronic bacterial infection, hepatic keratitis is under investigation. This anti-helminthic action of levimisole is neuromuscular paralysis of depolarizing type. The worms are then eliminated by peristalsis. These are the adverse effects: nausea, epigastric discomfort, insomnia, dizziness, weakness, drowsiness. Next drug is niclosamide. This drug is effective against all forms of tapeworm infections. These are alternative drug in case of intestinal fluke infestations. But a laxative is administered earlier to oral administration of niclosamide. These are the adverse effects: abdominal discomfort, pruritus, rashes. Main precautions and contraindications: the alcohol consumption should be avoided on the day and one day after treatment. Niclosamide in case of teniasis, 0.5 to 2 gram after breakfast, 1 gram to be chewed and swallowed with water, followed by 1 gram after 1 hour. For H. nana infestations, 2 gram doses repeated daily for 5 days. Next drug is diethyl carbamazine. This is mainly indicated in filariasis and tropical eosinophilia. It is absorbed after oral administration. This drug shows a dual action. Its hyperpolarization action decreases the muscular activity. Alteration in microfilaril surface membrane makes them susceptible to destruction by host defense mechanism. These are the adverse effects: anorexia, nausea, vomiting, and skin rashes. Urticaria, fatigue, dizziness, headache. These are some other adverse effects. Diethyl carbamazine in case of tropical eosinophilia, 4 to 6 mg per kilogram BD TDS for 7 to 10 days. For filariasis, 6 to 12 mg per kilogram OD or BD for 21 days. This drug is also used in case of prophylaxis of filariasis. Ivermectin, this drug is mainly targets the parasites GABA receptors. This hyperpolarization of nerves of muscle cells. This resulting paralysis and death of parasite. Contraindications mainly in pregnancy, meningitis, and this drug should be avoided who are taking benzodiazepines or barbiturates. Because this ivermectin mainly potentiates the GABA receptors. This mainly action on GABA receptors. Ivermectin is effective in controlling lymphatic filariasis, onchosclerosis, strongyosis, tuberculosis, ascaris, lumbricoids, cutaneous larval migraines, scabies, and lice. These are the adverse effects: nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, constipation, fatigue. Ivermectin in case of onchosclerosis, 150 microgram per kilogram single dose. This drug is also used in intestinal nematode infections and enterobiosis. For scabies and strongyosis, 200 microgram per kilogram single dose. Next drug is piperacillin citrate. This is effective in roundworm and pinworm infestations. This is the safer antihelmin. Piperacillin citrate. This main action is competitively blocks the action of acetylcholine and thereby contraction in the worms. So flaccid paralysis results and worms are expelled. So this piperacillin causes hyperpolarization and flaccid paralysis. This is the main mechanism of piperacillin: hyperpolarization and flaccid paralysis. And this drug antagonizes the action of another antihelmin, that is pendimethalin. Main precautions and contraindication in case of impaired renal or hepatic function, epilepsy, and chronic neurologic disease. Piperacillin citrate is mainly used in ascariasis, 4.5 gram OD 2 days, in children 0.75 gram, year of maximum 4.5 gram. Enterobiosis, 4.5 gram OD repeated after 3 weeks. Next drug is Prasikindol. This drug is effective against schistosomiasis, trematoids, cystoids and their larval forms. But this drug is not effective against nematodes. Is antihelminthic action. This causes spastic paralysis of worms due to leakage of intracellular calcium from membranes. Prasikindol in case of taniasis, 10 mg per kilogram single dose, and H. nana infections 15 to 25 mg per kilogram single dose. Neurocysticosis 50 mg per kilogram in 3 divided doses for 15 days. Nidazole, this drug is effective against schistosomiasis. It affects helminths by increase their rate of glycogen utilization, inhibits exogenous uptake of glycogen. It also interferes with the reproductive system of helminths. These are the adverse effects: anorexia, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, discoloration of urine with unpleasant musty odor. So this drug should be avoided in case of cardiac, liver and neuropsychiatric disorders. Ceramine, this is a newer drug, is a sulfate naphthalamine category used in first line therapy for early hemolytic African trichinomiasis. It's very tight protein binding, short initial half-life. Terminal half-life is about 50 days, excreted by kidney. It's also used for chemoprophylaxis against African trypanosomiasis. These are the adverse effects: nausea, vomiting, fatigue, dermatitis, fever, photophobia, hematolytic anemia, albuminuria, hematuria. Another drug is Merosporol. This another newer drug is chemically, this is a trivalent arsenical used for advanced CNS African trichinosomiasis. Is administered intravenously in propylene glycol and after administration it rapidly excreted. Is highly toxic drug used only in advanced trypanosomiasis. Adverse effects are vomiting, fever, abdominal pain, renal, cardiac disease, encephalopathies characterized by cerebral edema, seizure, coma and even death. This is a very dangerous drug and it is only used in case of alternative cases, not most preferred drug. Another drug is Iflornithine, is an inhibitor of ornithine decarboxylase used as a second therapy for advanced CNS African trypanosomiasis. After oral or intravenous administration, peak plasma level reach rapidly. Elimination half-life is approximately 3 hours. It is effective against advanced Treviso gemensis infections. These are the adverse effects: vomiting, diarrhea, leukopenia, thrombocytopenia, anemia, seizures. This is chart of drug of choice of helminthiasis. In case of roundworm, hookworm, threadworm, whipworm infections, benzimidazole categories of drugs like mebendazole and albendazole is the main first choice drug. Alternatives in case of roundworm, piperacillin, levimisole and ivermectin. Hookworm alternative drug levimisole, threadworm piperacillin is an alternative drug. For whipworm, albendazole and mebendazole. Next, in case of filariasis, first drug of choice is diethyl carbamazine or ivermectin, alternative drug albendazole. For guinea infections, metronidazole is most preferred drug. Tapeworm infections, first choice drug resicindol, niclosamide and albendazole. So this niclosamide is effective in all forms of tapeworm infections. Alternatives are albendazole, prasikindol and niclosamide. Hydatid disease, first choice drug albendazole and second choice mebendazole. These are the some nursing implications. First, look for worms expelled in feces. Teach patient proper hand washing and sanitary disposal of feces. All family members of patient should be examined and treated for worm infestations. Patient should take complete course of drugs as advised. Thank you so much for your patient listening. Okay, bye.